How you doing today? This is Randy with BC Roasters. We want to show you the new line of Clear Sky smoke suppressors. These are EPs, electrostatic precipitators that take your smoke and basically turn it into a solid and collect it on the ion filter inside, therefore reducing smoke up to 90%, which is great when you're in situations where you can't have smoke, whether it be a residential areas nearby or other businesses that don't want smoke coming out of your building and perhaps blowing into theirs. So we're going to go over how that's done. When you get this, it'll be crated and it'll have shrink wrap or something around it to protect it. And you basically just take it off and get it set up. Today we've got it set up with temporary piping attached to a BC5 roaster. The maximum amount on this particular Clear Sky unit would be a 2.5 to 3 kg roaster. If you get any bigger than that, you want to go up to the next size, which we have sizes that now go up to the 25 pound size. But as you can see, I've just got temporary flexible piping. If you were to do this as an install, you would obviously want to, in a building, you want to use permanent piping, which could be a flexible stainless steel piping running from the roaster to the Clear Sky unit. Normally you wouldn't run your cooling tray fan or exhaust through that because there's only one quick puff of smoke, and so most people just run that out separately. If you want to run it together, you'll need to follow the procedure that's outlined in our guides on how to connect both pipes together. So we're going to show you how this does with a 5 pound roast today using our BC5 roaster. Right now our roaster's preheating and the Clear Sky smoke suppression system is turned on. Every once in a while you might hear the clicking, which is basically the electrostatic precipitator zapping the dust particles or whatnot. And of course you'll hear that more probably when there's actually smoke running through the machine. I apologize again if you hear background noise. That's the fan to try to keep the sweat off my face, but we're going to go ahead and let that preheat. We're going to start the roast, and then we'll monitor throughout the roast, not only the roasting, so you can see the BC roaster, the new roaster, but also so you can see how much smoke I'll turn on and off the precipitator, and we'll see how much smoke we're actually saving. So here we are on the Clear Sky smoke suppression system. It's on, and I don't have, you can hear it clicking every so often. I don't have the our overhead door open because the light, the backlight, makes it hard to do video. But here you can see pretty much nothing coming out of there other than hot air. I've got it in a garbage can, which may help us to see the smoke when it does come out, but I'm going to kick off the ET just to see how we get some smoke, and hopefully I don't fill my building with smoke in the process. So I just clicked off the electrostatic precipitator, so in a minute you may start to see a little bit of smoke, and it's sometimes hard to see when you don't have it up against a particular color. But we're going to go ahead and let that go for a minute, hopefully not fill my building up with carbon monoxide smoke. Yeah, you can start to see the smoke starting to come out now. And what we're at right now is about 311 degrees on the BT. Yeah, you can see it. I don't know how well you can see it, but when it's over the gray, you can see it, but I don't know if you can see it on the video. I wish I had a better way to show you that. It's going to get more as time goes by. In fact, I'm going to have to open the door a little bit because I don't want to get asphyxiated here. Just let some. Yeah, you can start to see the smoke more clearly now. It's still not super high like it's going to be when it goes into first crack, and especially if you take it all the way to second crack. But you can definitely see the smoke coming out. Hopefully the video will show that. Let me see if I register it on the video. Yeah, I don't know if you're able to see it very well or not. Maybe if I hold it right there. So that's at about 363 degrees. Maybe if I put it in here. Yeah, if I put it, well, I put it above here. Now you can see the smoke really starting to come out. And you're going to hear the snapping. And you see all that smoke in there. And in a minute, you should see a reduction. So we haven't turned our precipitator off at all, and we're not really seeing much of anything other than heat coming through that. And right now we're at 392 degrees, and we're hearing first crack. This is Sumatra, so it starts a little later. So we should start seeing more smoke coming out, and obviously if the precipitator wasn't here, we'd be seeing a lot of smoke coming out during first crack. Start 430 degrees and you're really not seeing any smoke, but maybe just a teeny bit coming out of the precipitator. It's actually 438 degrees. I'm kicking off the gas. It's now 400. I'm going to go to 445. So we're at 445. So now I'm going to let the beans into the cooling tray. And sometimes when you do that, you see a little bit of smoke, but we're hardly seeing any smoke at all. Just a teeny little bit. So it's definitely doing a 90% smoke reduction, which is